What's up guys, Prodigy here, and welcome to episode 10 of Setup to a Showdown, where I review the setups you guys sent me and give my feedback. And if you want to submit your setup for the series, you can find the submission guide video down below. Now for today's setups, they're from Abdullah, Noah, Sanjay, Sabulch, and Lewis. And for this episode, I decided to pick out people with small setups because not everyone has a lot of room for gaming setups. So it'll be kind of interesting to see how they look. But anyways, thank you for submissions guys, as I very much appreciate it, but without further ado, let's get right into the video. Now starting off, we got Abdullah. He's 13 years old and uses his setup for gaming, watching Netflix, and doing schoolwork. And by looking at the photos, we can tell that he has a somewhat minimal but clean setup using the IKEA Mickey as his desk and a chair from IKEA. But getting to the equipment, he has a 24-inch curved monitor from ViewSonic, which has a fast 1 millisecond response time and 144Hz refresh rate. So for a single display, this was a nice choice. As for his peripherals, he has a mechanical TKL from HC Man, which houses blue switches, and then uses a normal HP office mouse. Now this gear might not be the best, but of course he can always upgrade later down the line, which I would recommend getting a keyboard that doesn't use blue switches as they can be annoyingly loud. But moving on to audio, he didn't list anything for headphones, so I'm gonna assume that he doesn't have any, but he does have a dual speaker setup. And as for his microphone, he apparently got it off Facebook Marketplace but didn't know the name. So just a reminder, if you do submit your setup for the series, be sure to label everything to the best of your ability as it does help for showing off your setup. But after going over all that, as of right now, he currently uses a laptop as his PC, but he did mention that he will be getting his first PC in a few months. So it's good that he got a good monitor already, as that's probably going to be a better gaming experience than what he has now with his laptop. But with all that said, Abdullah's setup is quite good starting out and looks pretty clean, especially with his cable management. And although his desk might be a bit small, I do like how he was able to have enough space for his peripherals without it looking super cramped. Now, if I had to give my opinion on what to change, it would probably be to get a bigger desk, as he definitely has a fair amount of space between his bed and his setup in the wall. Plus, I would most likely upgrade the keyboard and mouse to something better and also maybe add a poster to the wall or decorations of some kind, as the setup does look quite bare, but it is understandable with the amount of space that he has to work with. But overall, I like the setup as it's good for starting out and it looks fairly neat. Up next, we got Noah from Ireland. He's 15 and uses his setup for gaming and streaming, which just looking at the setup already, you can pretty much tell that there isn't much space compared to the last setup. But getting to the equipment, he has a 24-inch LG monitor as his main display. For peripherals, he has a Stormcrow Elite keyboard or blue switches, along with the Razer Basilisk mouse on an extended mouse pad. And for audio, he has a Blue Snowball Ice for his microphone, and then uses a Razer Kraken as his headset. And holding up all this equipment, Noah said that he bought a generic desk off Facebook, so maybe in future, he might be able to upgrade his desk to a bigger size. But after going over all the equipment, it's time for the PC specs. As of specs, he's rocking an RX 580, a Ryzen 5 2600 paired with a Kraken M22 from NZXT, 16GB of RAM, a 240GB SSD, and a 1TB hard drive all inside the H510 case. Now, in my opinion, I think this is alright for a budget, especially the RX 580 as I used it for 3 years and it got the job done. But I will say that I would recommend upgrading the CPU to a Ryzen 3000 series for better performance, and get a better AIO cooler since the M22 cooler isn't that good in my opinion. And above all, get a new case in the future because the H510 case from NZXT does not provide good airflow, which can lead to high temps for your components. So overall, it's an alright budget PC, but I would recommend upgrading in the future. But now moving on to the cable management, it's not that good, mostly for the fact that there wasn't an attempt to manage the cables, plus the cord on the bottom has a Velcro strap attached, but he didn't bother utilizing it to bunch the cords above it, so I would recommend getting some zip ties or Velcro straps to keep the cord together so it's more neat. But besides the cable management, I think this setup is alright, but you can tell that it's quite limited to the desk, so I would recommend getting a mic arm so the Blue Snowball isn't on the desk and to remove the extra mouse because it doesn't really serve any purpose. Also, I'm not too sure how I feel about the RGB strip behind the desk, because when setting up light strips, you want to see it glow, not the individual LEDs. But overall, I think Noah's setup is okay, but it does feel kind of cluttered with no space. Moving on, we got Sanjay. He's 15 and uses his setup for light gaming, photo editing, and just productivity in general. And we can see that he has a slightly bigger desk compared to the previous setups, but at the same time, it's still a small setup. But getting to the equipment, he has a single 22-inch 60Hz monitor from Acer, uses the Corsair K55 keyboard along with an Ergo mouse. And for audio, he uses the Kowon E7s as his headphones, and then has a Logitech Z213s as his speakers. So looking at the equipment so far, I think it's alright, but nothing too special. But I will say that I am a fan of the digital wooden clock, And fun fact, he does not have a desktop PC, but he does use his 2015 MacBook to power his setup, which I would recommend saving up for a PC because the specs of that Mac are pretty low. Now, although he does not have a PC, I will give him credit for the cable management because it's hidden in the cable rack underneath his desk, which if he wanted to improve the look of the cable management a bit more, I would probably recommend getting a cable sleeve. But other than that, I think it's alright. But looking at the setup overall, I like how it's simple but not too bland, as he does include some plants and he at least has some posters on the walls. And although there isn't any RGB lights in the setup, I do like how the color scheme of everything kind of works out and nothing looks out of place to me. So if you don't have any RGB lights in your setup, don't worry because it's fully possible to have a nice setup without the RGB, though you will miss out on the extra FPS. But besides that, I like Sanjay's small setup, but I would recommend getting a new PC, especially for productivity. Now near the end, we got Zabulk's from Romania. He's 14 and uses his setup mostly for gaming, streaming, and video editing. And first look at the setup, you can tell that there's a lot going on here, both kinda good, but bad. But starting off, he has a 60Hz Samsung monitor as his display, and then for his peripherals, he actually has a combo kit from Thunderstreak, which gives him a membrane keyboard, an RGB mouse, and then a headset, which does save money. But he actually uses a pair of Bluetooth headphones for his audio. And then for his PC, he has a GTX 1060 paired with an i5-9600K, 16GB of RAM, a 256GB SSD, and a 2TB hard drive. So it's a quite budget build, especially with the GPU, but I'm sure he'll be able to upgrade in the future. Now, this is where I would talk about cable management, but as you can see right here, there's absolutely no cable management in sight. It's basically non-existent. Now, I'm not trying to be rude or whatever, but this setup does not look good at all. And the main reason for that is because it's dirty and messy. And honestly, if you guys have a small desk setup like this, it should be easy to maintain it and keep it clean because it's not like you have a huge desk or anything. Like, bro, there's literally cobwebs behind the monitor and he took a picture of it as well, which means that he's just too lazy to clean. And speaking of cleaning, he needs to clean those cables everywhere, which I don't even know why he took this pic of a small cable just dangling. Like, overall, the setup is just quite disappointing in the lack of effort and is probably one of my least favorite setups I've ever seen. Now, some of you guys might be wondering on why I even chose to show this setup, and that's because I want to show you guys an example of what not to do, especially for a small setup. Because I do know that there are a lot of people that have a setup that looks similar to this. And honestly, if he just cleaned up his setup and just managed his cables, this would be a good budget setup. Because you guys gotta know that just because you don't have the best of the best equipment, doesn't mean that your setup can't look good. So overall, although I roasted this setup a little bit, it's honestly okay when it comes to equipment, but for everything else, it's just not that good. And then last but not least, we got Lewis from Montreal, Canada. He's the oldest on this list at 34 years old and uses his setup for photo editing, casual gaming, and watching movies with his kids. Which, just looking at the setup first glance, it looks really cool with the Space Jam theme and just looks clean overall. And he did mention in his notes that he opted for a Space Jam, Kobe, and Jordan theme because he loves basketball and it looks cool to his kids. He also mentioned that his space is quite limited as he does live in an apartment, so this setup is only 36 by 36 inches in dimensions, but he does utilize the corner of the wall nicely. And he also said that his setup was more on the budget side, except for the monitor, which is a curved 34-inch 1440p display from LG with a refresh rate of 144Hz and a 1ms response time, which is just a beast of a monitor in itself. And then for his peripherals, he uses the Havok Gaming Pro RGB combo, which his keyboard houses blue switches. Moving on to audio, he uses the Edifier WBT-800s as his headphones, and then uses the Edifier R12Us as his stereo speakers. And holding up all his equipment is the IKEA Bajerska desk. But now, let's talk about his PC. As a specs, he has a GTX 1080 Ti Founders Edition, a Ryzen 5 3600, 16GB of DDR4 RAM at 3200MHz, all inside the Corsair Spec 06 case. Which, you gotta admire the amount of customization going on inside the PC because it looks really cool, especially with the mini basketball hoop since I've never seen one inside a PC. And as a specs, I'ma assume that it works out well since he does have a beast of a monitor, but I'm sure that he'll probably upgrade his GPU in the future. And now moving on to the cable management, it's honestly amazing as all the cords are hidden and neatly set up, like the back of the monitor for example. But looking at the setup overall, I really love what Lewis did here, from the cool decorations, the RGB and color theme, and just how clean and neat everything is. And he also sent me a picture of his setup before he did all these upgrades, which is pretty cool to see how much has changed. So overall, I really love this setup as he adapted to the small space and still made it look amazing. But guys, that's gonna wrap it up for episode 10 of Setup to a Showdown. And I really like this episode, mostly because we gotta see how different small setups can differ from one another. Plus, if you have a small setup of your own, I hope you gained a couple of ideas and or tips. And I wanna say thanks again to everyone featured in this episode, because this video wouldn't be up without you guys. And if you wanna submit your setups to be featured in this series, be sure to watch my submission guide video in the description to learn how you can enter. But I think that's gonna wrap it up, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If so, drop a like and subscribe for more quality content like this, because I do love making videos like this one. Also, comment down below what you liked or disliked about the setups, and tell me which one was your favorite, as I know everyone's gonna have their own opinions on the matter. So make sure you leave your thoughts down below. Also, if you love the content on my channel, then I would highly recommend following me on TikTok, as I post daily videos on there similar to what I post on YouTube, which were actually almost close to 200k followers, which is insane. So if you'd like to see daily content from me, I would highly recommend checking out my TikTok. But anyways guys, thanks for watching and be sure to have notifications on so you won't miss any of my videos. My name's Brada J, and as always, stay classy.